makes me happy is to see all of us here. We are all doctors for a reason, and we will all, and nurses for a reason, and we will all continue to be doing our job until we reach a day when we think we can't continue anymore. None of these awards have attracted us towards becoming what we are today, and none of these awards will stop us from doing what we are doing today. We really love our job, and that's why we do it. Ours is not the easiest of jobs. It's the most stressful of jobs. It's tedious, it doesn't pay well, and a lot of frustration. Like Murthy Garu has been saying, the media is always against us. Sometimes our own fellow professionals are trying to pull us down. The patients don't seem to understand what we are trying to say, and this is a job which starts with frustration, ends with frustration. But what is it that makes you get up and go to your work every day? What is it that's making you check your phones? You want to see which patient is in need of you and when you need to go back and start working, operating, seeing the clinic and all again. So our job doesn't need any award as such, because we are motivated enough to do what we do. But sometimes it's really nice when your colleagues have nominated you. You know, you're all here because someone out there is thinking you do a very good job. So they nominated your names. Murthy Garu didn't choose, or any office didn't choose. Your fellow colleagues nominated you, and that's something to be really proud of. And let's continue to do what we are so good at doing. And it's so nice of people like Murthy Garu to once in a while stop us and say, look, keep working, but just come take this award and then go back to work. And one thing the pandemic taught us is how much people love their lives, how much people fear for their lives. I took a break from, not a break, but oncology gave me a break. No patient ever came during the lockdown, you know, nobody would come. And got a bit bored, then I thought, okay, they are short of staff on ICU wards, COVID wards, so I'll go and do some work on the COVID ICU, just because I was bored. And somehow I was never frightened of getting COVID, and I thought, if I get it, I'll survive it. Whatever, call it overconfidence, call it whatever. I thought, if I get COVID, it's okay, I'm immune enough, I'll survive. So I went to work there. And so many times when people were at the end of life, we knew somebody would pass away. Sometimes we would offer the family members to come and have a conversation. You know, some old people couldn't do the FaceTime video calls. They had a mobile, they had a smartphone, but they were so breathless, they couldn't connect on a video to the family members. They were in isolation on ICU, so the family couldn't see them. They couldn't do the video calls. And much as you try and sit next to them with a phone on and say, look, your daughter is there, you want to say hello, this man's breathless and barely able to talk. So a few times we offered the family, do you want to wear a PPE and come? He only has few hours. They'd say, vodule doctor garu, vodu, risk kada, meeru cheppe seyandi. Something like that. It happened so many times. I had so many family members who would come with a bit of kumkum from God, puja, and say, please, can you go and put it on their forehead? And you'd say, I just came out of a PPE. And no, we did the puja this morning, it has to be done. Then one kind nurse, you know, my respect for nurses has gone up from 100% to 1,000,000% in the pandemic. They are constantly working, you know, with those things on. They won't eat, they won't drink, but they would just work. And then they would go, okay, ma'am, I'll go and put. So the own family members who were so frightened they will catch corona would not come and see the patient. Even the end of life, the body is there, covered up in the PPE gear, you know, the COVID positive body to be disposed of. They would stand 6 feet away, do a namaste and say, okay, you can allow the ambulance to take it to the funeral house. And there we are trying to feed them every day, clean their mouths, help them, you know, do physiotherapy, without worrying that we might catch COVID, or worrying but keeping that worry down and putting the patient first. And there's their own family members who wouldn't even want to come and touch them, not even once at the end of their life. And that tells you what we are made of. And I think it's, we honor ourselves every day, we congratulate ourselves every day for what we do, and then go back to work the next day, taking all the risks associated. And then these awards are like a little feather in the cap to what we tell ourselves every day. So please give yourself a very, very big clap for what you are. And let us not become demotivated by what others say about us, what the media says about us, what the patients or their relatives say about us. Let's put 200% into what we do and continue to shine the way we always shine. And I'm very, very happy for all of you out there. And next time it's your turn to go and think who those wonderful colleagues of yours are and nominate them.